everyone, welcome to the channel. It's me, Andrea, and in today's video we're gonna go over a Middle Eastern fragrance that I am so happy to have in my collection. Y'all, I think I have officially entered my Middle Eastern fragrance era, and this is bad. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. If you are a new viewer, welcome in. Consider joining the family by clicking on the subscribe button, turning your notification bell on so you are notified whenever I do upload a video. So you guys are getting me in my workout clothes. I sprayed this fragrance on earlier today when I was just going out and about, just trying to see how I liked it, because I was kind of skeptical in the beginning. But honey, this fragrance changed so much on my skin as it was going through the phases of, you know, initial spray, the middle part, and then the dry down. I'm absolutely in love with this fragrance. I was on the hunt for like a replacement for my J'adore L'Or. I had the 2017 version, and I wasn't really trying to drop those kind of coins right now. I'm supposed to be on a no buy, but I was just searching and searching and searching and searching, and I came across this fragrance by Latafa. It is called Massage. Y'all, if you don't have this fragrance in your collection, you are truly missing out. First off, look at the bottle. It is so stunning, so chic, sleek, classic, all that good stuff. The top is beautiful. Oh my gosh, it's weighted. It is just gorgeous. This is a gorgeous bottle with gorgeous juice on the inside. According to Fragrantica, the main accords of this fragrance is white floral, powdery, rose, musky, citrus, sweet, and animalic. It says the top notes are orange blossom, jasmine, floral notes, rose, powdery notes, and white musk. You know, it does have a beautiful atomizer. That is so pretty. A wide spray on it. Oh my goodness. I really don't agree with the notes on Fragrantica at all. This fragrance is just, I don't know, it's just something else. When this fragrance first opens up, I get a burst of citrus notes, like a bergamot, a lemon, or something. Although the top notes say something totally different, that is really what I get when I first spray this fragrance. It smells so good, y'all, from the beginning to the middle to the end. You know, and as this fragrance started to dry down on me today, I began to get like a citrusy rose. Now, the rose in this fragrance, in my opinion, is kind of sharp. It's not pungent, but it is kind of sharp. But it's still pretty. It's like a bouquet of roses. And I don't know why people are not talking about this fragrance that much, or maybe they are, and I'm just now finding out about it. But when I tell you, I love every stage of this fragrance. Now, I do agree with the middle notes of this fragrance, because I begin to get this rose. It's a sharp, a really, really sharp rose, but it's surrounded by some citruses, like bergamot or lemons or limes or something. It's some kind of citrus in this fragrance. But also in the middle, you start to pick up something green. And that's why I think this fragrance has patchouli in it. It has to have some kind of patchouli note. And when I say patchouli, like, you know, I don't mean that dirty, dark, deep, real earthy patchouli. It's just enough to bring some balance to this fragrance. You know, because it is full of sweet white florals, full of that sharp rose, but that patchouli just brings some balance to it. That's why I just feel that the notes that are out there on Fragrantica are not the right notes for this fragrance, because I get something totally different. Yeah, I get something totally different. I don't even get any musk in this fragrance. This is not a musky fragrance to me at all. The dry down is where the magic completely happens. You have to enjoy rose and white florals to enjoy and appreciate this fragrance, because in the dry down you get a bouquet of roses surrounded by a white bouquet of flowers with some patchouli. It's sweet, it's creamy, it's just gorgeous. It is so pretty. Like, if you like something like J'adore or any of those white floral forward fragrances, or the Gucci family, I forgot what they're called, where they're like heavy on the magnolia and the gardenias, you would enjoy this fragrance. But it's those kind of fragrances mixed with rose and some citrus in them. Oh, this is pretty. When I tell you guys, I could not stop smelling myself. Majaji, however you pronounce it, this is a gorgeous fragrance from La Toffa. Guys, I am so happy with this fragrance. I can see this fragrance being worn by any age group, you know, late 20s and up. Now, this fragrance is a heavy hitter for sure, so do be careful on the trigger. You don't need a whole lot of sprays. I do think that once this fragrance macerates, it's going to perform so good in the spring and summer. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to wear this. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful fragrance. I cannot say it enough. I cannot stress it enough. If you do not have this fragrance, Mazaji by La Toffa, in your collection, family, you are missing out. I promise you, this is worth the blind buy. And guess what? This is only $18 on Amazon. $18. This fragrance is done well. It does not have any kind of, like, I wouldn't say, oh, it costs $18, I can tell. No. I will put this fragrance against any designer fragrance out there. I will put it against J'adore. And J'adore L'Or, the 2017 version, I love that fragrance. In my opinion, this fragrance is not for the weak at heart. Because if you spray too much of it, I can see this fragrance becoming kind of cloying or kind of even maybe headache inducing. So if you do purchase, please go light on the trigger. Now I can see this fragrance being beast mode when it completely macerates, because I sprayed it today about 8 hours ago and I can still smell it on my skin. That's why I'm here doing this review in a baseball cap and a workout shirt, because I just had to come and tell you guys how I was feeling about this fragrance initially, and it's been a complete day of wearing it. If you don't have it, go get it. It's only $18. I will try to link it down below. I'm not good with the links, but I will try for you guys, because I think every woman, man, child, human, boy, girl, whatever, should have this fragrance in their collection. This fragrance reminds me of like a clean girl type aesthetic. You know, her apartment is probably modern. You know, it's probably one solid color. Nothing is ever out of place. It also reminds me of someone wearing all white linen. Like, no wrinkles in the linen at all. Just pure white linen with a bouquet of flowers in their basket, just at a farmer's market. This is a beautiful fragrance. Or if you're going out to dinner with your guy or your girl, it will work for that occasion as well. I can see someone wearing this fragrance, you know, to the office, to church, to, you know, brunch. It doesn't matter. This is going to be one of those easy reach type fragrances every boss lady should have in their collection. This can also be a signature scent. It is just that good. But I do say this fragrance, in my opinion, leans more to the feminine side. I can see myself also rocking this a complete spring and summer. I do think it might perform okay during the winter. Depending on where you are, might not be like one of those frigid cold type days, but you know, just maybe the early winter, you might can get away with this one. But I would say definitely in like the spring and summer. And that is Mazaji by La Toffa. And since I'm in this Middle Eastern era, I'm gonna keep this going. This week I will drop a video every day reviewing a Middle Eastern fragrance in my collection that I feel will work great for spring and summer, so that we'll have time to get them in, let them macerate, and enjoy some beautiful fragrance from our Middle Eastern companies. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. If you are a new viewer, welcome in. Consider joining the family by clicking on the subscribe button and turning your notification bells on, so you are notified whenever I do upload a video. And until next time, bye.